this short video, we're just going to try and show how we have learned to peen an Austrian scythe blade. Basically, we start from the tip, working towards the heel. This is backwards. A lot of people start from this end, and this comprises of two hammer motions. One, we do multiple passes, and we do like this. It's kind of locking this joint and just moving that bar. And then we do multiple ones of those until the blade is as thin as we want. And then starting from this end, the last pass, we do just a straight down one. And this time we lock this joint. No, we only move that joint. Now on the last pass, we start from here, and we just lock that joint. We do a hammer action like this. So I'll just show you for a minute. You're the lucky one, I know that now. Don't ask you why, when, where, how. You look at the world. Once we've done multiple ones of these, every time cleaning it with a whole edge key so we can see where the hammer falls. And once the metal is as thin as we want and we test it with a thumb, as shown somewhere else, then we do the final part like this, and we do a hammer motion up and down. So we only move this elbow joint. It goes like this. First of all, we want to remove and round this awkward corner. We'll use a file or a chainsaw. We're just going to hold our thumb like that. So that it's nice and round. Now we want to just remove the paint and the lacquer from both sides. So we use the same file, the tip of it. Then we use our finger, our thumb, as a guide. Just scrape along. It's about half a centimetre. Everything's gonna be I'm angling the peening slightly. If I angle like that, it tends to go off, and then I cut my finger. So when I remember, I'm not distracted by the film, try to do it at an angle. You're the lucky one. between the edge. Trying to do it in such a way so it doesn't eat into the sanding block. That's why I don't scrape the other side until I've sanded this one. Because when you scrape it, it tends to get a little bit sharper. I don't know if this is the same for everybody. Just how I'm doing it right now. Turn over and we're going to scrape the other side. Squeezing this between my knee, holding this. Also I've got my finger underneath here, which I push up against the anvil to stop it from sliding backwards and forwards. I hold it like this. Eventually I use this knee to support the tip as the tip comes this way.